we're getting some much needed fresh air at the Metroparks.
We didn't really realize this until probably about the turn of the century, the 21st century. What forest therapy does for you and forest bathing is it helps you sleep better, it lowers your blood pressure, it lowers your heart rate, it reduces inflammation, and it increases your overall psychological well-being in an incredible way. It's not the kind of thing that will replace your medical routine, whatever that is, or your doctor, but it will absolutely enhance your health. We have Metroparks around here that are just gold mines for healing that way. I'm Kim High, Master Interpreter for Metroparks Toledo, and I am also a certified forest therapy guide. Forest therapy translates from Japan's term shinrin-yoku, and that means forest bathing. And what that is to us, how that translates, is getting out into the forest or a garden or any natural area in your locale, your favorite place, and just taking in the elements of the forest or the natural area around you. We also do some small programs called Try It, Habitats for Healing, and that's forest therapy. And then we have longer 3-hour forest immersions where we actually go out for quite some time, we bundle up. This is a service that we can give everybody in the area, Lucas County and surrounding area. And so we really encourage people to get out. I just really want to invite people to find healing and use the Metroparks this way.
Seeing how Equality Toledo is making sure our community is well taken care of.
Hi, my name is Sheena Barnes. My pronouns are she, her, they, them, and I am the Executive Director of Equality Toledo. We are at Equality Toledo's headquarters that we just established a year ago at 440 Floyd Street. Everyone is welcome here at Equality Toledo headquarters in our pantry. Doesn't matter if you identify as LGBTQT+ or not. We are welcoming to all families from here, and we also serve those surrounding Lucas County. No one comes to our pantry will be turned away. I think personally, I reflected on my own journey with food insecurity to make sure that it's feasible for folks who work, because while we have late hours and weekend hours, we also make sure we have pop-top lids. So we think about our population that we serve in different aspects, but I think the biggest one is that we are no barrier. And so we wanna make sure everybody meets the need, make sure they get fed, and make sure they feel loved through Equality Toledo. It's like any other thing, you may go to a doctor, but it's 100 things going on, and you're just focusing on that one. So we try to make sure we meet the dire need of food, but also see if they need recess for dental, for, you know, physical, therapeutical, anything that else can we can help with. So we see all first as food insecure, but we also know there's underlying, especially with the pandemic happening, mental health has been a really big resource needed for everyone. Just to know that we are meeting someone's need, we're here, and we're not judging them for why they need it. It's overwhelming sometimes to know that a small space can, you know, give so much love out of it. And we're looking forward to just really helping those who want to start a pantry that's LGBTQ+ affirming, and hopefully they'll do something of this nature and we can blossom all over Lucas County.
Checking out how furry friends might be exactly what you need in the new year.
Hey everyone, I'm Faith Atkins with BCAN, and with me in studio today is Cassie Bloomfield from the Lucas County Canine Care and Control, and she's here to talk about the benefits of having a furry friend during quarantine.
So having a furry friend to spend time with, to pet, that is a huge stress reliever. Just the motion of petting your dog, having someone there with you who loves you unconditionally. They're there with you all the time if you need just someone to hang out with, if you're trying to be active, go for social distance walks, that kind of thing. They're really helpful just for that. And, you know, just having a companion with you all the time. The dogs were really, really important for that, and cats too, of course.
Not only, you know, do you gain a furry friend, but it kind of builds a community with other pet owners, and you can learn tips, right?
Absolutely. Social media is really big now, of course. So there's a whole community of pet lovers on there. You can join forums and talk to people. And our community here, our dog loving community in Lucas County, is amazing. So there's great resources and great companionship. And you can make new friends that way too. When we have 20 plus adoptable dogs, they're still waiting for their homes. So if you're in the market, it's a great time to adopt a dog also, because you have lots of time to train, get them acclimated, that kind of stuff. So any way you can help is great for us.
Now that you know what's happening in Toledo, here's what's happening near you.
Make a trip to the Toledo Museum of Art for the last week of Picture ID, Contemporary African American Works on Paper exhibit, ending January 17th. Get your thinking caps on for Stubborn Brothers weekly Tuesday trivia. And crank up the heat at Ernest Brew Works for their spicy beer heat week, starting January 17th.
Stay tuned, more Be Can Pals coming your way after this short break.